everyone. It's Scott Pyre, Pop Cult Fan here. And in this video, this morning came some pretty big news for one of my personal favorite TV shows. And it's a superhero show. And let me give you 5 seconds to see what that possibly could be. Dun-dum, 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 Smallville, which first aired in 2001. Which means this year, 2021, it's the 20th anniversary of Smallville. And this morning, they just announced that they're doing a revival with Tom Welling, this guy right here, coming back to not just star as a character again, but also as an executive producer on the show. So Tom Welling, he's got some free reins for this new revival that they're doing, and it's going to be animated. They're going to do an animated TV show for Smallville. So, yeah, this is one of my personal favorite superhero shows, not going to lie. So, I have season one, and I have all 10 seasons. So, I'm going to not, like, do, like, a full review talking about all the seasons individually, but, like, just give my general thoughts on the show as a whole, and just kind of touching upon like my history with the show, because I didn't grow up watching the show, but it was in high school that I started buying all 10 seasons. I was like on a buying frenzy when I was in high school, and I bought a lot of movies while I was in high school, and TV shows. I was getting into TV shows a lot more, and I came across Smallville, and beforehand, like, I was already, like, a Superman fan, like, before I watched Smallville, and because I've seen, like, the movies. I've seen the movies with Christopher Reeves and with Brandon Routh, and also, I know that Superman has a long history in live-action television, because back in the 1950s, there was the Adventures of Superman TV show with George Reeves, and then it was around the time, like, after, like, the Christopher Reeve movies were finished, they did a Superboy live-action TV show, which was essentially a Superman show, but Lana Lang was one of the bigger characters on that show, and they did a few different versions of Lex Luthor on that show. And then not just that Superboy show that they did, but they also did Lois and Clark, The Adventures of Superman with Dean Cain and Terry Hatcher. There was that show, and then Smallville. So, and now that we're living in 2021, there's now the Superman and Lois TV show. So, Superman has a long-running history with live-action television ever since the 1950s, and that's crazy to me. So, yeah, giving my general thoughts on Smallville as a whole. The first few seasons, like seasons 1 to 3, are some of the better seasons, in my opinion. Just, like, because it just really delves into that whole family dynamic with Clark and his parents, Jonathan and Martha Kent, and also Michael Rosenbaum, his version of Lex Luthor, which, real quick, like, if I had to give my favorite version of Lex Luthor in live action, it's Michael Rosenbaum on Smallville. He's easily my favorite version of Lex Luthor throughout all these different live-action interpretations of the Superman mythos that we have had to this day, even with John Cryer's version of Lex Luthor on Supergirl and Crisis. I still consider Michael Rosenbaum my favorite Lex Luthor out of all Superman mythos live-action television. Because Michael Rosenbaum, he gave a lot of range and a lot of depth with the character, because we were able to understand him throughout the course of the show, and seeing his kind of descent into villainy as the show went on, because he didn't start out as a bad guy. He tried really hard to be a really good friend to Clark at the beginning of the show, and you can really see that friendship sort of developing and then crumbling as the show went on, especially in the first three seasons of the show. And that's one of the things that makes me, you know, really admire and appreciate this show for what it did, because it grounds the character in a lot of ways. No tights, no flights with Tom Welling's Clark Kent. But you have to appraise the show for what it did all the way back then, because back then we didn't have the Arrowverse, we didn't have the DCEU, we didn't have the MCU. So it was around that time, back in the early 2000s, when Smallville kicked off and became something so unique and different, while at the same time paying respect to the Superman mythos. It did an amazing job with all of that, and with what it did at the time, and how in the second season, Christopher Reeve, the actor that played Superman in the 70s and 80s films, he actually made a few cameos on Smallville as sort of a passing the torch to Tom Welling's Clark Kent, which I thought was easily one of the best episodes of the entire show, when Christopher Reeves first cameoed in season two of Smallville. And I do have a few issues with the show, because in the middle sections, like in from season four to season six, there's this whole love triangle between Clark and Lana and Lex that just really like bogged down that aspect of the show quite a lot for me in those middle seasons, because of the whole teen romance kind of drama that was going on between Clark and Lex and Lana. And it just felt very CW-ish, I guess you could say, now that we've been seeing so many other superhero shows on the CW with the Arrowverse. And Smallville was kind of the show that started that trend. And it... That's one of my main issues with Smallville in general. It's just those middle seasons are my least favorite seasons of the show. But it was still enjoyable. Like, obviously, I still really liked Erica Durance. Like, even to this day, like, on Superman and Lois, I really do really like Elizabeth Tulloch's portrayal as Lois Lane on the Superman and Lois show. And I might do a separate video talking about season one of Superman and Lois at some other time, because I'm really, really liking Superman and Lois. It's the only Arrowverse show that I'm watching right now, so that's a show that I'm really liking. Like, it's an amazing show. But I'll talk about that another time. So, Smallville, in its later seasons, like seasons 7 to 10, I think they were getting a little bit better with the writing, especially with the last two seasons, seasons 9 and seasons 10, was when Clark was finally starting to embrace his hero persona as the red blue blur, or the blur in season 9 and season 10. Yeah, he had a nickname before he had the Superman name. He was called the red blue blur in season 8, and then in season 9 it was just the blur, because he just changed his outfit to this black trench coat with the Superman symbol kind of sprayed onto the chest area, which it's kind of reminiscent of the black Superman suit from the comics, which, now that I've seen that in live action on the Justice League Snyder Cut and on the Superman and Lois show, that's the first time I've seen that aspect of the suit, the black Superman suit from the comics. The first time I really saw that in my brain was watching Smallville. And in general, like, when I first started watching Smallville, there were only two characters that I really knew in DC, and that was Superman and Batman. And the show just kind of expanded my knowledge of the DC universe as a whole, because it introduced so many DC heroes from the comics in the show, like Green Arrow, for example. Green Arrow, Aquaman, and Bart Allen, his version of the Flash on the show, and all these other characters like Dr. Fate, Hawkman, and Blue Beetle. You know, so many characters from the comics were introduced on Smallville, and that really just that expanded my knowledge of the DC universe as a whole. And now I'm really like, I'm fascinated with whatever they do next in DC with live action, with any other characters that they do. And Smallville was the show that really got me invested with like the comic book world as a whole, not just with DC, but with Marvel as well. And that's something I had to give credit to Smallville for introducing me to this bigger world of superheroes. And it's, again, just something that I hold very dear to me as a show that not only introduced me to the bigger world of DC, but also gave me a much bigger appreciation for the Superman character. Tom Welling's version of Clark Kent, he's the reason why Superman is my favorite superhero. With truth, justice, and the American way. Yeah, Superman and Spider-Man are my two favorite superheroes. And it's easily, like, in that final season of Smallville, they did this version of Darkseid that wasn't, it wasn't great. I'm glad. That's why I really liked the Justice League Snyder Cut, because we finally got a proper live-action version of Darkseid. Because when they did the final season of Smallville, the way they portrayed the character on the show, it was just kind of odd, because it was more of like a dark force that you didn't really see, because it like manifested like its own kind of shadowy kind of figure in the very beginning of the season, and then in the last episode, this dark force kind of possessed this alternate universe version of Lex's father, Lionel. So there was that, but it was kind of eh. So that's one of my main issues with the final season of the show, just what they did with Darkseid and how they treated that character. And yeah, like, but overall though, like, I really love Smallville. It's easily my favorite superhero show next to Gotham, which I have done reviews for that show in the past on my channel. So yeah, so overall, just easily one of my favorite superhero shows of all time. And that's pretty much it. So yeah, I can actually, you know, before I end this video, I'll show you guys like all the shows or the seasons of the show. This is season 2, season 3, season 4, when they introduced Erica Durance's version of Lois Lane. Also, by the way, even though I do really appreciate Elizabeth Tulloch's version of the character, I still kind of prefer Erica Durance. I just thought, like, she's like probably the most relatable version of the character to me, because of how her character kind of balanced out with Tom Welling's version of Clark Kent on the show. Yeah, Erica Durance, she's still my favorite Lois Lane, even though I do really like Elizabeth Tulloch on Superman and Lois. Erica Durance is still my favorite Lois Lane. Man, this is season 5. This is actually the season that introduced their version of Aquaman. And also, season 4, they introduced their version of Bart Allen, aka The Flash. And season 6 of Smallville, this was the season that introduced Justin Hartley as the Green Arrow. And also, like, on the back, like, as you guys can see, they did their live-action version of Justice League on the show. So that was before the Snyder Cut, that was before the DCEU, before the MCU. The very first, one of the first live-action versions of the Justice League that we've had was in season 6 of Smallville. Huh. And then also, it was season 7 with Clark's cousin, Laura Vandervoort, as Kara. So, yeah. And then I also really liked how in season 8 and going forward, Clark started working at the Daily Planet, which felt very reminiscent of Superman shows of old, whenever Clark worked as a reporter for the Daily Planet. That's just a version of the Superman mythos that I've always really liked, how you can relate to Clark Kent because he works an everyday job as a reporter for the Daily Planet, and you know how his characters are balanced between Perry White, the editor, and Jimmy Olsen as the freelance photographer, and Lois Lane being his romantic interest. That's just a version of the Superman mythos that I've always appreciated, because it's something that you can relate to, because it's like an everyday kind of workplace to be in for the Clark Kent's persona, and I've always liked that, you know? So, season 9, this is the Black Superman suit that introduced me to the concept of the Black Superman suit right here. So yeah, and then obviously the final season of Smallville with the shadow of him wearing the suit, which I guess that is one other flaw I do have with the series finale of the show, because we never really got a chance to see Clark Kent like actually suited up, because whenever we did see him in the suit, it was always from a distance, and they used CGI, and that was one of the few issues that I had with the series finale of the show. So yeah, like that's pretty much it for what I wanted to say about Smallville, and I'm really looking forward to this new revival that Tom Welling is working on, being an animated TV show. So it is a TV show, but it's animated, so that's something to look forward to. So who knows when that will come out, probably within the next 2 or 3 years. So yeah, that should do it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys liked this, and I will catch you all in the next video. Peace.